Hey there, everyone. Eizen the Broniac here, and welcome back to the Final Fantasy V 4-Job Fiesta Run. don't mind me. Just making sure that when I'm doing this game, that I make sure that the sound quality of the game is loud enough that I can hear it, but not too loud that it overpowers my voice. Anyone that remembers parts 1 through 5, they'll know what I'm talking about. But anyway, now that we're back into this game, all we have to do now is head back into the castle. Head back into the castle. Not even gonna attempt to be like, but guys, seriously, it's me, King Galoof. Let me in. It's just, well, we tried once. Apparently we did everything we could, and that was nothing. So now, that one secret where we found the great sword actually comes into play here. Because now we can sneak back into the castle. Just kind of expecting. Monsters are here! Kill them all! Oops. Or whatever. It's alright. It's all fine. You're good to go. Have that man executed. So, now that we did everything we could, obviously. The next best thing we can do is to heal up the dragon. Heal up the dragon, but of course, no. Krill is far more important. But then again, to be fair, with a portrait like that, I suppose it would be important. Shh, don't talk, honey. This will all be over in a second. Bam, 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 bam! You know, as much as I didn't like the name Gil, that sounds far better than Guido. And yes, that's a great way to start up a video. And welcome back to the 4-Job Fiesta Run. God, I hate this fucking game. It's like the same one note I keep playing with this. So yeah, we know what to do. We know how to progress. Let's just kill the damn dragon already. No, I don't want to eat grass. That makes you high. Yes, with the wounds he has, it'll kill him. No, I'm telling you, I don't want to eat the gra- whatever. And plump. Reyna, you're such a fool. Drink this! It's called my fist! Yes, that is far dangerous, especially when you're sick and helping others. Just saying. And I swear, the dialogue in this game still makes me mad. It's the small stuff, at least. That's what pisses me off the most. But I'm gonna tell you, I'm actually gonna be so happy once next year comes around where I don't need to worry about the dialogue and just skip everything. Because by then, I'll be using an emulator, and it'll be far easier to skip through that stuff. All because we're pressing the fast-forward button. Yeah, even Kraken believes me. And in case you're wondering why I'm calling the dragon Kraken, just remember the big battle of the big bridge and stuff. Otherwise, don't ask. Just don't ask. So yay, once again we have access to a dragon! Whoa! And now we are able to see this Guido. Except for one slight problem. And that problem is... Earthquake! So, aside from advancing the plot, what was the point of this? The answer, folks, absolutely nothing. Oh, that Exdeath. See, I told you we should release the Kraken, and that's clearly what that Windrake would do. Just be released from the sea like a Kraken. So, anyway, as you can no doubt tell, that place is pointless to visit. However, there are still some other stuff that we can visit and see along the way. Actually, if I could bring up my map, there we go. Oh, you know what? I bet it's to the west. What I'm looking for is probably to the west. Heading over here. Yep, this is the castle I was thinking. Surrogate Castle. State your name and business. Yeah, only now does it play in effect. Mm-hmm. Yes, and he's got a stupid mugshot. Just saying. Stupid mugshot. Anyway, here there are at least two things to get, which is some gold and a white magic spell, which, if memory serves, I think we can actually use. Unless I'm thinking of... Oh, it's time magic. Never mind. It's not important. I'm going to get it anyway. Because that's clearly my top priority. Getting stuff I don't need. Because, you know, if you're going for 100%, you just gotta do it. Also, probably pointless, but I'm gonna check anyway. Scholars. So now, we have to put the books away. Forbidden book. No. What about you? Ah! F for forbidden. Next up, register of monsters. Oh, definitely no. Ah! R for register. And you are... Weird Ronka, which I think is... Yes. W for weird. So now we watch her as she heads back to her room. Via secret compartment, apparently. I mean, don't all people live in secret compartment areas? Somewhere in this castle. By somewhere, probably right here. No, that's the gill. Uh-huh. For those of you who don't know, it's talking about the summon Shout, or, I already forgot what it's called, Cataplevus, I'm gonna sound like an asshole at this point. I'm just gonna call him Shout, because that's how I remember that, bull demon who's able to petrify you on sight. It's gonna save me some trouble if I just call him that. I suggest you remember that if you want to control that. And also, I noticed that you were. Oh, never mind. Just something to waste my time. And I already have all the treasures. All the treasures. So, the only other thing left to do here, if you want to call it something to do, is to find a local shop. At the shop in this town, and just buy stuff. And yes, as you know, that tell just by reading that book, we learned the Swift Song, even though it's completely pointless. I think this. Ah, yes, here we are. Let's see, weapon and armor shop. Items and magic. So let's see. White magic, don't need. Black magic, all caught up, don't need. Time magic, we definitely don't need. It's not that important. The equipment? Nope, we're fine. Weapons! Oh! There's actually something that's a bit more powerful. Well, two, actually. Another great sword and a poison axe. I wonder, is there anything we could sell? No, there is not. Oh well. Actually, had I known that there were more powerful stuff to get, I probably would have done some off-camera grinding. But you know what? That's perfectly okay. Because next up, we are going to, insert name here, ship. I already know who that person is, but considering they're giving him a different name compared to the others, I'm just gonna say, what's the point? Zezot. I just prefer Zezot, even though, either way, it doesn't sound good. Oh well. If there's one good thing about this next battle, is that we once again get to fight our friend Gilgamesh. Also, I'm trying to be careful, because I'm actually using, I'm using a potato chip clamp in order to keep my pages intact here. You know what? It might be weird, but if it keeps the pages from, flipping back and forth, then yeah, I say it's helpful. Anyway, we finally meet Zezot, and they plan to strike an attack in order to weaken Exodus' barrier. But before we do that, let's get some rest. If I get some rest, I mean let's ride our dragon. No. No, I wasted enough time as it is. In fact, probably, just took long enough as it is just trying to do this. So, I think No, that's just the barracks. But notice how they say they're digging a tunnel. That's gonna be important for, immediately after this battle. And I think I automatically get healed. Especially if I rest up, so let's just do that. Before you know it, attack! And this is how you know Gilgamesh is with them. Battle on the big bridge. Or in this case, battle on the big ship. But hey, who's keeping track of that? Bam, 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 bam. This fleet's just a decoy. We'll buy some time. monsters have now come aboard the ship. There's Gilgamesh. Not even a splash, just into the water. Yes. Listen to what he said. Leave the trash to him. Why is it that important? Because, apparently, it doesn't matter. We go up against him anyway. And what you saw, I was gonna say, I'm pressing the attack button. Will you get back here? What the hell am I talking about? That doesn't even make sense. I'm acting like Chuck Conroy insulting the Germans here. I am so sorry, everyone. And I just noticed for a brief moment that monster was apparently a bit bigger. Oh, if nothing else, that gobbledygook died in his sleep. Oh my god, why are you missing so much? Why are you missing so much? Attempt to entangle, which is gonna make a difference because attack. By the way, right next to us... yeah. Notice he's not attacking the same monster. But there he is. Down for the count. But apparently he's back. And notice that we can't ride the dragon again. Just to show you, no, you've come this far, you may as well continue with your battle. But that doesn't matter, because once again, we fight Gilgamesh. Now, I'm not sure if there's anything that can work here. But let's bio him first. See if, we can drain this. Golem, so we have physical defense.
Are you kidding me? What? What?
Oh, that is so pathetic. That is so pathetic. I'm just gonna remind myself. I'm actually gonna do this fight again properly because we're supposed to be fighting his friend Enkidu, who's supposed to help him in this fight, and it's supposed to be much more epic than that. So apparently, I have to do some off-camera grinding so I can replace his death sickle with the poison axe, but. For now, let's just move on. That was terrible. That was terrible. Ugh. And guess what? Even though he doesn't make it, Arwen Drake saves us.
I'm gonna say anytime you're ready, you can come back up there.
And that's pretty much how exciting that fight was. I mean, one deathsicle strike, which apparently made him susceptible to death. And that happened. Yeah. I wish it were more entertaining, folks. I'm sorry. But don't worry. We'll make up for this, I promise. Also, it's the same door. So now we have a new vehicle by our side, which is resting in chairs. No, in all seriousness, it is a submarine, a new transportation thing for us to travel under the sea. And, wow. Were those chairs always able to do that? Oh, that matters. That's how this barrier works. If one tower goes down, apparently the whole barrier completely screws itself up. They couldn't have backup generators. They had to use that. So, is there any treasure in here? There are four of them. Two gold, two of them are items, which, according to my strategy guide, have monsters in the boxes full of them. But before we do that, let's go see our good friend, who just told us to not worry about him and continue onward, and yeah. Well, that sucks. See, this is why we wanted to see our good friend. Because he knows that stuff. And I believe, yeah, dance stuff are auto-hit. If they successfully do anything. So, thank goodness the jitterbug came in place when it did. Yay, got the hit. Yay, got the hit. Could you do a dance move for me, please? No. Well, can this at least kill it? I'm not entirely sure if that killed it because of death or because it did enough damage. Anyway. But I want to go with you! And remember this room. Just remember that room. It's going to play an important part. Trust me on that. And we have another save point. So, I think before we continue onward, let's just do that, save ourselves some trouble. Alright. So, we're gonna do that. And I'm actually gonna cut this part a little short. Not because I wanna cut it short, but because I wanna add room for the true Gilgamesh fight. So, with that said, I'll see you in a minute. And we're back, folks. Okay, now, as you can all tell, I did some off-camera grinding. I got the poison axe for Buds, which apparently is just 5 attacks stronger than the death sickle. But you never know. I think I'll keep the death sickle for the time being, because you never know. Easy victories are sometimes the best victories in life, right? Oh, and I also got another great sword for Pharah, so that way she won't be left in the dark. But with that said, let's actually try this fight again and do it properly. Probably like the game developers meant for it to be, instead of just broken beyond belief. So let's silence our blade. We don't need a text. Shim can't cast shell, attack. And did it? It did not poison Gilgamesh. But that's okay. That's perfectly okay. At least now we have a physical defense blocking us. And of course the first attack he would use is missile. Fire! And did it silence him? I think it did. Yeah! Look at Golem doing its job for us. Here we go. Enkidu! Yes, this is the guy who I was talking about. Now this fight can properly get underway. And it seems like, yeah, because he's flying, it only affects Gilgamesh. However, now what I'm gonna do is, aside from Berserker for obvious reasons, I'm going to try to focus my attacks on the Enkidu. Let's try to silence it so it doesn't try and cast that spell again. And I think for this one, I'm going to try and do the stun block. As far as I can tell, it doesn't really do anything, but Slash is still there, and as powerful as ever. Good to know. Also, now that I've gotten that, let's give this a shot. I highly doubt it's gonna work, but you never know. You never know, folks. Let's get Ramu here. Judgment Balls. Ow. It's a powerful death claw. Hey, stop that. Yeah, that's right, you better fail. I'm not gonna say that attack was worthless. Yet. Know what I'm saying yet, because it missed altogether. Had it hit, you never know, it might have worked. That's it, let's try again, shall we? And it's immune to... Shame, but considering it's a boss fight, I kind of expected that to be the case. So now, let's see. Yo, let's have Shiva have some fun. Ice. Maybe. And yeah, Golem is still in effect. Okay, so now that we know that's not gonna work, let's cast Bio on our blade. So if nothing else, we can at least try and poison them. Or by poison, I mean it's the sap, and your missile failed. Haha! Speaking of failed, your attack failed because Golem is still in effect! Yeah! Let's celebrate with the Hellfire! Now I'm hoping that I can, kill Enkidu first, and I'm kinda not surprised about that. Let's try Sylph. So it's fairly weak up until this point, but, you know, let's give it a shot. Whisper Wind, decent 300. And another powerful wind slash attack away. Would you stop it with the death claw? But I guess if anyone, at least I'm glad it's on Bunt, so he can at least stop doing physical attacks on Gilgamesh every 3 seconds. That's right, you better miss. And yeah, let's just cure Butts for that now, shall we? And would you stop missing already? Heal all. Yeah, this fight does tend to drag on a bit. That's because I want to go for the funniest ending of this fight. Is it necessary? No, but I want to get the funniest ending out of it. Wind slash. Ha! Ya missed. Ya missed. Not to mention, it heals my party, so why not? Stop attacking us with that wind slash. And stop missing already, damn it! Miss the wind! There we go. So now I will have absolutely no regrets when it comes to eating Gilgamesh. And how could you miss? That's a shame. And even throughout all this, Golem is still in effect. Got it! Here we go. Faithful sidekick, Enkidu? Hey, you're not supposed to dead Steve Hero! Or whatever that. But anyway, that's gonna do it for this episode of the Final Fantasy V 4-Tap Fiesta. If you like what you see here, be sure to subscribe to my videos and actually check out my other channel down in Daily Motion, where it's got Let's Plays, Eyes and Tries, and even some blind reactions to MLG stuff, amongst many other stuff as well. So, with that said, I thank you for watching. This has been Eyes and the Broniac saying, take care, everyone, and I shall see you all later. Next time we meet, we'll be back at the save point at the power antenna radio thing. You know what I'm talking about. I'll see you then, folks.